Okay, so this is a Sony Bravia Android Smart Television, and I'm going to review this video. On this video, I'm going to review this TV, of course. Right, so I've done several other review videos on individual apps that you see on my screen at the moment. So if you want any specific app to be reviewed or need more information, I would suggest you go through my other videos. If you have any specific questions while I take you through the TV and what features, benefits that it has over any other standard smart television or from any other brand apart from Sony Bravia, just post in any questions in the comment section and I'll be happy to respond back to you. Right, so this is a Sony Bravia W800 series Android TV, and normally when you switch it on, it would give you the Google logo while logging in. The first thing I would say is that it takes a bit longer compared to any other smart television to boot or to start when you switch it on. And the reason behind that is because this has an Android operating system, which is much more powerful than any other operating system on any other smart TVs. It switches on a number of resources, background processes to run, and that's why it takes not hugely, but maybe around 30 to 45 seconds longer than a standard smart television from Samsung or LG. Yeah, so that's one I would say negative, but there are a lot of positives from this Android TV. The first thing I would suggest is always go with Sony Bravia. If you can afford the cost, look for deals that are available in the market, and if you can buy a Sony Bravia, that's even better. If not, then I would say buy a standard 4K television and buy a $50 or £50 Android TV box that are available in the market quite easily to purchase from Amazon or elsewhere. That will make your TV anyways powered by Google Android. And why I say we need an Android TV is because of this particular reason, where you have Google Play Store. So Google Play Store, like you have on your Android mobiles, allows you to download millions of apps. The only restriction here is that as it is on your smart TV, it will allow or show up only apps that are compatible for TVs. Not every app that you see on your Android smartphones under Google Play will be appearing under television Google Play, and that's because it has to be compatible with TV. So, but I think these days, any good streaming app for HD content, 4K content, standard content, for fitness apps, games, so there it has a good variety or range of games as well. If you have a kid or a child or yourself, if you're crazy about games, these are just some examples that are showing up which are popular, but it has a really good variety or range of apps. If you have any questions on what apps are available, I can search it for you and tell you, but just ping me that app name and I'll find it for you on Google Play on the Android TV. Right, so stream, these are music apps, as you can see. These are the popular ones, entertainment apps. You can see in here, the ones that I use are on my home screen. I'll show you later. But these are the customizations that you can do as well. So business apps, communication, health and fitness, entertainment, music. So these are the categories in here. So all you need to do is maybe go here and search and type the app name and it will appear here, right? So that's one way of searching. So otherwise you can go into the categories and first search it for yourself. So if you compare it to any other smart TV from Samsung, LGs, which are largest selling smart televisions, this one gives you a wider and much more bigger range of apps that can be downloaded, and these apps get added really quickly. So there will be more and more apps every time you log in. That's what I see here as well. As how God's not hundreds or thousands, it's got millions of apps in there, right? So that's one benefit. Google Play Store is definitely important, plus the range of games that it gives you access to. Right, okay, so that's one benefit, Google Play Store. Secondly, if depends on your region, you will find some featured apps. So even if you can't find BBC iPlayer, ITV Hub, etc. on your Google Play Store, so if it is coming from Sony Bravia and you see here Sony Select, there will be apps that Sony has tie-ups with, and they will be appearing under featured apps like BBC iPlayer, YouView, Rakuten TV, ITV, Channel 4, MyFive. So these, I'm in UK at the moment, and this shows you region specific featured apps. Yeah, if you are in India, US, UAE, wherever you are, or in Europe, somewhere in Europe, it will have a different range of featured apps. Okay, now these are the apps that I have downloaded or come pre-installed with this Android app, TV. So Google Play Store, YouTube Kids, I mean, this one I have downloaded, AirScreen, and these are some Asian streaming apps that I have downloaded, BT Sports in UK, Replica is for screen mirroring or casting from your standard TV or standard smartphones to a TV, VPN unlimited, and I mean browsing, so Puffin browser, Google Chrome is what I use for browsing on smart TV. That's one benefit. I mean, you don't really get a browser or a good browser on your smart televisions, and Android TVs allow you to download them. So Puffin TV can be downloaded from Google Play Store, but if you need Mozilla or Google Chrome, there are other ways to download it. I've done several videos on how you can download the APK file, and if there is any certain app that's not available on the Google Play Store, there are still ways you can download it. So watch that video, and you should know that it's, I mean, virtually possible to kind of download any app that you need on your TV in that way, right? Okay, right. It gives you HDMI ports, 2 to 3 ports, depending on your TV model. So you've got 3 HDMI ports, or maybe 4 HDMI ports in a way. Then it gives you USB ports as well. Okay. And if I go to settings, and I quickly show you the benefits in here, why it's better, right? So if you go under apps, it will show you what are the apps that are running at the moment. And if you go to any particular app, it will allow you to uninstall it, tell you the storage, clear cache, clear data. That will allow you to clear some space in there. Notifications and what sort of permissions you want to give that app. Yeah, if you just want to allow storage space to be used, if you have camera built in or any other thing installed. So it gives you a range of apps, and you can play around it and allow you to uninstall it from time to time. Also, when your television gets frozen, because that is one thing that happens a lot with these smart televisions, I mean, because there are so many apps running, so many processes running in background, sometimes what you would find is it comes and interferes with freezes your TV. And what you can do is go there, force stop it, yeah, and that will release the resources being occupied by that app. It is similar to killing any sessions in your laptops or smartphones, yeah. So that will just kill that particular app or the session that is running for that app, and then it will bring your TV to normal. Yeah, you can keep clearing your cache, clear data, or uninstall it from time to time as and when required. If you're not using that app, I would recommend you delete it. Storage space, I mean, you could easily factory reset it, and it would become as it came from new from the factory, right? If you go to about, it allows you to install the software updates or operating system updates. You can set it as automatic, so it will be downloaded as they like it, or you can switch it off and do it manually when you like it, right? Okay, fine. Similarly, I mean, TV model, what is the latest version running, and so that you can check the, if you're downloading or installing any particular app, you can check against the operating system version that you have and whether that app is compatible or not. That's very important, because if you get an app which is not compatible with the hardware or the operating system that you have, it interferes a lot, uses a lot of memory and resources, and that makes it go slow. So I've done a separate video on how you can improve the performance of your television. If you're not really very happy, you can always improve the performance by following those tips. There are close to 10 tips that I've given. Make sure that you are following them, and it will definitely improve the performance of your TV. And when I say performance, if your TV is sluggish or slow, or it freezes a lot, crashes a lot, then those tips will help you improve the performance in that respect. Okay, similarly, there will be settings for display and sound settings. You can get surround sound or 3D display, etc., depending on the TV model. So you can see in here picture quality, whether how you want to see it, I'll just quickly show you the settings that you have, but I've done again a separate video on the settings, etc., that you get within your Android television. Yeah, I've set it as standard, but you can clearly see some difference coming with each setting. Yeah, so I'll put it as standard again. But yeah, you can see the range of options that it gives you. Yeah. Okay, so I think it has given you some idea of what an Android TV from Sony Bravia looks like, what options do you have, and whether it's a good option to go with that, or would you go for any other smart television from other TVs, if you or TV brands. If you have any specific questions, and like screensaver, is there any other feature that you want to know about, let me know and I'll be happy to respond back to you. I would always recommend go for Android TV if your budget allows that. If your budget is tight, then go for a standard television which HD or 4K picture display, and then buy a Android TV box that will make your TV again Android based and give you the same features. Yeah, watch my videos on the channels that will give you reviews or deeper insight on how you can best use your smart televisions, reviews on apps, settings, features, etc. Like my video if it has been useful, subscribe to my channel if this area is of interest for you, and put in your comments in my comment section, and I'll be happy to respond back to you. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you. Bye bye.